For many, many years, Gentleman Jerry Valiant was, again, my type of wrestler, as you might say. But at times, the fans cheered him, and at times, the fans booed him. He really didn't care. You know, I don't either. They do not help you win the match. And today, we're going to look back at Gentleman Jerry Valiant to see what type of wrestler he was and one of the famous Valiant brothers.
Waddell's leg is actually draped under the bottom rope. I guess there's a plane there, which an imaginary line which the referee goes by as to if he should break the hold.
Look at his hand turn to blue. The blood's going out of it.
The blood is going out of the hand of Jim Waddell. His hand is turning blue. You people with color television. I tell you, this Valiant really taking care of business. Man, he comes down with that foot and another one, kicking away on Jim Waddell. That arm completely immobilized now. Once again, holds onto that hammerlock.
All he's got to do is give up.
Valiant yelled over here at me, all he's got to do is give up. I tell you, you got to give Jim Waddell a lot of credit for hanging in there. Man, Waddell is yelling in agony. No, he's got a chin lock of some sort, along with that hammerlock, still holding on to the hammerlock. Runs that elbow down into the shoulder area. This hold is immobilizing the whole arm from the shoulder to the elbow, right into the finger area. They're backed up against the ropes now. Valiant in command. Solid forearm by Jerry Valiant. Another forearm by Valiant. Does it again. Solid blows by Jerry Valiant. They're on the ropes, though. Waddell is mercifully just hanging on. I don't know. It's actually the referee's judgment now if he wants to continue this bout. Waddell saying, no way, I don't want to give up, but I don't know if it might not be for his own good for the referee to end this bout. Now an arm bar, but now he has again, once again, turned it into a hammerlock. Solid punch into the midsection by Jerry Valiant as Waddell was going for a headlock. No dice. Got that face lock applied along with the hammerlock. Jerry Valiant from New York City. And I tell you, I don't know if this was his plan before this bout, but he has stuck to his game plan on Jim Waddell. He's draping that arm onto that rope, and he comes down with a solid fist and another fist by Valiant, once again pounding into that arm. Holding on to that arm bar. Referee again asking Jim Waddell. He says no. He's got it in a hammerlock again. Very, very dangerous. It looks bad for Jim Waddell. There's very little life left in that arm. It's turning blue. Waddell is definitely in trouble. I'm really concerned, fans, for Jim Waddell right now. You never want to see a wrestler get hurt, seriously. Though it is a legitimate wrestling hold. But putting on so much pressure, I honestly don't know how Waddell's held on. They're on the ropes. Waddell with the advantage. I don't know if he can do much of anything. He comes back with a forearm, another forearm by Valiant, he's coming down. He's coming down with that forearm. Now running the head into the turnbuckle of Jim Waddell. I tell you, Waddell's took a lot of punishment. He's got that arm again. He's got that arm again into that hammerlock. I don't know. The referee is going down to ask him. They're calling, yes, yes. The referee has said no way. The referee has called for the bell. Valiant will not let go. Let's get it official right now. Ladies and gentlemen, continuing to use the hammerlock, Jim Waddell has given up. Your winner, gentlemen, Jerry Valiant. Valiant. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know the condition of Jim Waddell. Gentlemen, Jerry Valiant used that hammerlock to tremendous, tremendous advantage to himself in this bout. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if he gave up or if the referee just ended the bout. Jerry Valiant yelled at me that he did give up. Wait a minute. Valiant throwing a kick into Waddell. Ladies and gentlemen.
Back to the show again, fans. We welcome you back, and we've had a lot of excitement today.
One time.
But up next
one time
is our
only.
Feature match.
That's right. That's what he told
ninja,
you.
Who is
I'll do it one time.
Shredded,
but I'm wearing
unknown,
a robe.
Shady, spooky
what?
Kind of character up against Electric Eric.
He told
Frito.
You that.
A little more excitement.
Oh, that's part of the plan,
wrestler.
Huh?
And
he knows what he's doing. He knows
with
what
the
he's
ninja,
doing.
All right. There's a word about another
okay,
ninja coming
I'll make
in for our tag team competition.
All right, we'll see you.
or at least that's what my co-host here, Dallas, has been hinting at. The other ninja?
There's two ninjas.
Is he going to be here for the tag team competition?
Both ninjas will be in the tag team competition this Saturday, and they're taking on Fire and Ice. And I predict that the ninjas will defeat them because, one, they're better wrestlers. Two, they have the professor. And three, superstar TJ Powers has purchased the controlling rights to the ninjas. You're not going to beat them. The next champions. But, you know who that was?
Well, no.
That was my brother, Austin. We've come to an agreement. And I'm going to tell you something, and I'm going to tell all these simpletons something. Your wish has came true. Big Rig Rollins, Gentleman Johnny Walker, you got it. This Saturday, St. Nicholas Bingo Hall, 7 o'clock. Big Rig, get in that semi, pick up Walker down the road, and come on in to Indianapolis because I accept. My brother and I came to an agreement. One match. One match. That's all it'll take. And then I'll get back at the business of hand of Bobo Brazil Jr. But fans, you want to come on out because it's the end of the line for Big Rig and Walker. That knee's going to get hurt worse. One match. But as I've said, I'm still wearing the robe.
Help yourself. But why don't you
help myself
on the tag team competition there? That way.
No, we're not in the tournament.
Fire and Ice.
We're not in the tournament.
Against the ninjas.
The commissioner didn't put us in. That commissioner, I got questions about him. That guy looks. I'm not sure. He's got bodyguards.
Huh? He well ought to. As commissioner of a Pro Wrestling International's wrestling.
One match, Walker. One match. Now let's go look at this ninja.
Let's see, the ninja up against Electric Eric Freedom. Let's see what they have to offer here for you, fans.
From out of the 60s.
Well, PWI fans, this is Dave Hewitt again, and along with me, Dallas James, the Texas Playboy, and we're going to take a look today at Mr. Electric, Eric Freedom, the man straight from the 60s.
And his opponent.
And he is facing a tough one, Dallas James.
I'll tell you what, this ninja, I've said it before, I believe I said it on our debut program here in Indianapolis, yeah, he's on the high side.
Right now he's making his way to the ring there, flying the war flag. That war flag there of the Far East, being accompanied by his manager.
The professor
there, coming to the ring, carrying one of his martial art weapons with him, while the ninja flies the flag. Now, the professor's made his way into the ring, Dallas, and Eric Freedom, definitely one of the up-and-coming rising stars here in the PWI.
Yeah, see, he made a cardinal mistake now. Maybe he does that back in the 60s, but you don't do that in the 90s.
Well, the ninja's definitely going right at him here. Going at him, throwing those chops and the karate blows into the throat. Attacking him from behind, getting the upper hand from the very beginning, Dallas, from the very beginning. Sneak attack, as we've seen from the ring before. The ninja going out, but turn around here is Eric Freedom.
Electric Eric Freedom is a wrestler that's been around for a while. Come into PWI and, like I said, he's no newcomer. The ninja may have his hands full with Eric Freedom. But I'll tell you what, I've seen this ninja. You've seen the ninja.
I've seen him.
This is one scary individual, and the rumor has it again. The other one is on the way for that tag team tournament here in a couple of weeks.
There's no doubt if they bring in another one at the same
next week is my thoughts. This is coming up this Saturday, the beginning. This coming Saturday, February the 4th.
You're so right, Dallas James.
First round, and you got the ninjas, and I got a scoop.
What's that, Dallas?
I got a scoop. Tell the world.
Let's hear it. We got somebody else to unmask here?
Oh, boy. Are we going to try to unmask the ninja? I've got a scoop, and the scoop is the two ninjas. It's been announced. Yes. It was on the hotline.
Did you call the hotline?
I finally found the quarter, and I called the hotline. I missed who the Lone Ranger was, but I guess we all know who that was. The ninjas in first round action. Now get this. In first round action this Saturday night at St. Nicholas, we'll meet the number one seeded team, Fire and Ice.
Fire and Ice.
Then that's a main event in any arena, and that's first round action.
That should bring the fans out to see the PWI action, the PWI tournament taking off this coming week. Oh, man. Can you believe how quick this ninja
is? Did you see Diamond Dan on the end of that?
There is a place pilots talk about, but few have ever been. It's a place where training, aircraft design, indeed a pilot's ability to stay cool, are put to the absolute test. Presenting the Challenge of Flight. An exclusive new series that takes you where no aviation videos have ever gone before. Start with Final Approach. Be there when it all goes wrong. When raw power, fear, and the ejection seat is all the pilot has left. In incredible detail and first-hand accounts, you'll see what happens low and slow over a pitching carrier deck. Gear up with nowhere to go. And in the bunker when you test how bad it can be. Be an eyewitness to history as you watch exclusive footage declassified and released here for the very first time. Order your copy of Final Approach and go where few pilots have ever been before.
Use your credit card and call 1-800-474-8800. Other tapes will follow. Cancel anytime. There's no obligation. Call 1-800-474-8800.
It's tough being a fan when your team isn't the home team, especially when I try to find coverage of my favorite team in the local paper. I'm lucky if I can find last week's score. But if you're like me, you'll be happy to know there's one publication that'll make you feel right at home. The Sporting News. You'll love the Sporting News, no matter what team you love, even if it is the home team.
Call this number now and get four issues of the Sporting News free. You'll get opinions and analysis, team-by-team reports, and coverage of all the college conferences, plus baseball, basketball, and hockey all year long. Call now and you'll get four free issues of the Sporting News. If you like them, you'll get 24 more issues at this great TV price. If not, just mark the bill, cancel, and owe nothing. The four issues are yours to keep.
So call now for the Sporting News, the publication that treats every team like the home team.
Call now and you'll get four great issues of the Sporting News free.
Call 1-800-998-5577.
Not to take anything away from Eric Freedom, but we're talking about the top tag team combination of Quicksilver and Diamond Dan.
Well, I think when the ninjas are done with them Saturday night, I'll make a prediction. Ninjas will defeat Fire and Ice. There will be an upset. I don't think it's an upset, but that commissioner, I'm telling you what, that commissioner, there's another story right there. That guy's with the mafia.
Let's just back off this topic here, Dallas. Let's get back to the action in the ring. As you see, Eric Freedom coming back here, delivering a volley to the head of the ninja, working him over in the corner, setting him up off the ropes. Setting up kind of a flying bulldog there of some sorts, Dallas. Freedom going for the cover here.
My brother taught him that.
We have seen some similarities in that move from this unmasked man from his European stint, one Austin James.
Another one. I believe that will do it. And I think Quicksilver or Diamond Dan get used to that position, because come Saturday night, one of you, if not both of you, is going to be just like electric Eric Freedom.
A force to be reckoned with. And if the professor's bringing in one more of these, I don't know, it may be what you're talking about, Dallas James. An upset in the tag team tournament.
Hey fans, you saw it there. The ninja did defeat his opponent. Very quick, agile wrestler. He did know a lot of the martial arts moves. I have to admit, if there's another ninja like him and they tag up, I certainly hope Fire and Ice are ready for the challenge that awaits them when the tag team competition starts.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dallas is pretty excited about this. And I have to give you credit. Those wrestlers, if the ninja is like this ninja, then they will have their work set up for him. Fire and Ice certainly will. Anyhow, fans, let's this go ninja. Now to PWI Live so you can see where we'll be.
There's two ninjas.
Two ninjas. Well, for today's segment, there's only one ninja that we just saw. That's what I'm saying. If the other one is like him, then Fire and Ice
better. He's better.
We'll see when the tag team competition starts up.
He's stronger, and TJ Powers owns him, and the professor manages him. I'm telling you, Fire and Ice are done. They're fizzled out. They're done.
Well, fans, we welcome you to come and see that action. But right now, let's take you to PWI Live so you can see not only that date and time, but other exciting events.
But the one everyone's talking about, ladies and gentlemen, is when Pro Wrestling International returns to the St. Nicholas Bingo Hall on Saturday, February the 4th, with a 7 p.m. bell time. This will be a special edition, a TV taping of Wrestling Fever. Plus, you'll see first round action of the World Tag Team Tournament. In one-on-one competition, superstar TJ Powers will battle Billy Joe Eaton. Pro Wrestling International returning to the St. Nicholas Bingo Hall on Saturday, February the 4th, with a 7 p.m. bell time, St. Nicholas Bingo Hall, located at 3456 North Shadeland Avenue. All tickets are priced at $5. The doors open up at 6 p.m. Action gets underway at 7. Pro Wrestling International, Saturday, February the 4th, 7 p.m. at the St. Nicholas Bingo Hall. Plus, you've heard it, the big challenge match will be met. Big Rig Rollins, Gentleman Johnny Walker, against the James Boys. Let's now hear from Big Rig Rollins.
Dallas, I begged you last week to sign the match. But nothing. No call. You haven't contacted the attorneys. Wait a minute. Hello? Yeah, John, what do you need? They signed it. Next Saturday night. St. Nicholas Bingo Hall, 7 o'clock. You're sure? I'll get back to you. Dallas, Austin, you signed your careers away. You did the stupidest thing on earth. You decided to get in the ring with me when I'm mad. So let me tell you something. Next Saturday night, St. Nicholas Bingo Hall. Dallas, you bring Austin because he doesn't want to face the traffic jam. Because I've got one just for you. And if Austin doesn't like that, there's a roadblock in it for him also. So, fellas, you just cowboy up, as they put it down in Texas, and I'll put you out of wrestling.
It is a celebration of excellence. 75 years of NFL memories. And to honor this diamond anniversary, we proudly present the NFL's 100 greatest touchdowns. The greatest TDs of all time in one remarkable video. The great runs and the great runners. From Jim Brown to Emmitt Smith. From Walter Payton to Barry Sanders. All the superstar quarterbacks from Namath to Montana. From Unitas to Bradshaw. This is a video classic. The NFL's 100 greatest touchdowns. Order yours for just $19.95 and you'll get this special collector's edition art print tracing the 75 years of the NFL. This is an exclusive TV offer.
To order, call 1-800-642-1411. That's 642-1411. Or send $19.95 plus $4.95 shipping to Greatest TDs, P.O. Box 339-AL, Verona, New Jersey.
Hey, hi, folks. Hey, you know, Blue and I are sitting here in La La Land in the hot sun, and we got to thinking. Maybe there should be no more hitting in the game. Maybe you should take out those nasty disagreements. Make it more like a silver ballet. No more rock'em sock'em hockey. Maybe... Nah.
Quality Video presents the all-new Rock'em Sock'em 4. Hockey the way it was meant to be played.
Over 40 minutes with the best hits, goals, saves, and other stuff, if you know what I mean.
And if you're looking for the best in hockey, look no further. Quality Video also brings you top 50 playoff goals. Gretzky, Lemieux, Bobby Orr, all the superstars of hockey. Rock'em, Sock'em 4, and top 50 playoff goals. Both incredible videos for only $19.95. This incredible offer is not available in stores, so pick up the phone and get in on the great hockey action now.
If you think you play like this, but you really play like this, you need help. You need Leslie Nielsen, star of the new home video, Bad Golf Made Easier.
Billy, the reason the game is called golf is because all the other four-letter words have been taken.
Leslie Nielsen's Bad Golf Made Easier teaches you the fundamentals.
Always remember the only really useful tip in golf is the one you give to the starter.
Secrets the pros won't tell.
Never use the comb in the blue fluid.
And how to play the problem lie. It's the smash hit home video. Call now to order. Leslie Nielsen's Bad Golf Made Easier.
What is our credo?
We don't play golf to feel bad.
We play bad golf but feel good.
Call now to order Leslie Nielsen's Bad Golf Made Easier. Only $19.98. This video makes the perfect gift. Rush delivery available. Call 1-800-544-9339.
Welcome back,
I bet you play golf like that.
No, Dallas. Welcome back, fans. And as a final wrap for today's show, our highlights included the tag team of Fire and Ice, Bounty Hunter, Superstar TJ Powers, our classic of Gentleman Jerry Valiant.
True gentleman.
Not to mention
not like
one,
Walker.
Not to mention one of the two ninjas. We await the presence of the other in our tag team competition coming up. Lots
next,
of excitement.
The next champions are the ninjas. You heard it here.
You'll have to wait and see with that one, folks. But we invite you to come on out and watch us live. Join us again next week. And I have to give you credit, Dallas. You finally did it, you fool. You took the challenge. You took the challenge against Big Rig Rollins and Gentleman Johnny Walker. You and your brothers finally put your big boy pants on. You're going to go out there and wrestle with the men.
If we put our big boy pants on, we'd be wearing Rig's pants. Both of us could get in them.
Well, fans, that's an exciting one. Let's see what happens with that next week. And thanks for tuning in. Remember, fans, catch it. Wrestling Fever.